A very good evening to one and all. This is batch number two, and our project is Air Canvas, which is free and digital painting canvas developed using artificial intelligence. Our mentor is Prabhakaran sir. These are the contents of the PPT. And coming to the abstract. Well, talking about the abstract, Air Canvas is a free and digital painting canvas where we can draw anything on the digital canvas or simply a screen by just waving our hands freely in the air without any restraint. Here a colored object or a stylus at the tip of the finger is used as the marker. The project is based utilizing the computer vision techniques of OpenCV such that one can draw anything on the canvas just by capturing the motion of the stylus in the hand. The preferred language is Python due to its exhaustive libraries, and it is OpenCV supported language. Here there are various algorithms which are used to achieve this particular objective, which include color detection and tracking algorithms. It further includes the steps of morphological operations of erosion and dilation. Air Canvas is actually based on a very important concept of free air interaction, which you'll be learning in further slides. New sensing technologies allow free air gestural sensing, which enables precise sensing of both fingers, hands, and other objects in the air by placing the sensor in directly in a line of sight with the display. Visual connectedness with the remote canvas or the screen is established. This concept is utilized here in our proposed project to paint on the canvas through the air as if it were directly on it. We evaluate the whole system through an informal walk-up and play installation and study, developing implications for interaction design using this type of precision-free air interface. Introduction. Well, as I told you earlier, Air Canvas is a free air digital painting canvas where we can just draw anything on the canvas by waving our hands freely in the air without any restraint. So the main motivation behind this project is actually two reasons. It's based on two reasons. The first reason is that you see many of the schools in India cannot afford to buy a huge screen or good infrastructure. So most of the students in India are facing this crisis, not able to study in good schools or have good infrastructure to study. That was the first reason. And the second reason was that you see most of the teachers are facing allergic problems by using traditional chalk pieces. So these are the two reasons which motivated us to build this particular project. And this project is very effective project, which can be useful to most of the people and society, because here all we do is write in air and just single screen or PC captures them all. Also, it is the most trending technologies which is set to revolutionize schools as well as businesses and the daily lives of people by avoiding the need for a medium to write by using a technology called as zero touch. Well, as I told you, the main idea of our project is free air interaction. So let us know what it actually means. Free air gestural interaction is a very hot topic nowadays. At least amidst Corona, where touching things is completely prohibited. Here, it actually enables precise sensing of both fingers, hands, and other objects in the air by placing the sensor in direct line of sight with the display, with which the visual connectedness with the remote canvas is established. This concept is utilized here in order to paint on canvas through the air as if it were directly on it. Unlike most of the previous technologies where pen and touch interactions are used here, touching the surface of your PC or mobiles is at all not required, believe me. Well, you see this concept, we are not the ones who invented or innovated it in the first place. There also have been many inventions in this particular field of AI. I'm going to show you some examples. You can see here in the left side, it is the example of LG Air Motion, and in the right side, you can see automatic kinetic door 2.0, and both of these are the examples of touchless technologies, and Air Canvas is also an example of touchless technology. So free air interaction is based everywhere. Existing systems. Existing systems would include touchscreen. A touchscreen is simply a computer screen that can be used by touching it with a finger or a stylus pen instead of a mouse or a keyboard. There are different touchscreens which are used in today's market, such as smartphones, tablets, smartwatches, kiosks, automatic teller machines, GPS navigation systems, and interactive whiteboards. To tell exactly about the disadvantages of the existing system, there are no disadvantages to tell actually. When we move to the existing system, to the proposed system, there is just an upgrade. We are just moving from touch screens to touchless screens. It's just an upgrade, but there are no disadvantages with the current existing system, I assure you. The proposed system. Well, as I told you earlier, the proposed system goes beyond specs of finger-based touch technology. Rather, it is based on an innovative technology called a zero-touch or touchless technology. Our project is based on this very touchless technology, which utilizes the golden concept of free-air interaction, which I explained to you earlier. By placing the sensor in direct line of sight between an artist and the PC screen, which we generally use, the artist can paint on the screen through the air as if it were directly on it. Here, a colored object at the tip of the finger is used as the marker or a stylus, simply. We use the OpenCV techniques to achieve this particular objective to recognize and map the movements of colored object in the hand onto the screen or digital canvas. And to talk about the sensors used here, since we are using a PC screen, the sensors which are placed in PC are simply image sensors. Domain. Well, this whole project belongs to the domain of artificial intelligence. Until recently, networks have been designed solely for operation by humans, like touch technology, where we use touch screens and our touch is required for it to implement. Like, without our touch, it won't work. But then this is about to change. As automation and AI technologies improve, zero-touch networks of the future will soon be able to automatically determine which actions to take with minimal human intervention. An example of which is 8 Canvas, that is our proposed project. The domain, as I told you earlier, it belongs to artificial intelligence or simply AI. So what does AI actually mean? Well, AI can be defined as anything that makes machines act more intelligently. AI is a wide-ranging branch of computer science concerned with building smart machines capable of performing tasks that typically require human intelligence. Libraries and modules used. Well, here the libraries and modules used, there are particularly three libraries used, which is OpenCV, NumPy, and Collections. OpenCV is a Python cross-platform library using which we can develop real-time computer vision applications. And NumPy is just an inbuilt library of Python, which is used to work with arrays. Collections is a Python module that implements container data types, such as dict, list, set, and tuple. Architecture. Well, the left side, you can see the pick of architecture of Air Canvas. There are 5 steps which are involved in it. First, taking live input video feed. Second is color tracking. Third is contour detection. Fourth one is frame processing. And the first one is algorithmic optimization, which I'll be explaining it to you in the further slides in detail. Implementation. Well, first thing we do here is that we import all the necessary libraries and modules, which I explained to you earlier. 3 modules are imported, which are NumPy, Collections, and OpenCV. And after importing necessary libraries and modules, we define boundaries for colors. That is, to track our marker, we need to define the boundaries of its color. Next, we shall define our color palette. We are going to use various colors in our color palette to be used by our marker to paint in whose space, color space. This is known as color tracking. And after that, we now take the live input video feed. And after taking live input video feed, we apply image smoothing techniques, which are, we use morphological operations in order to smooth the image. And the morphological operations just comprise of 2 functions, which are erosion and dilation. And after that, we use hand gestures to control our color variables. To do so, we capture an image, Gaussian blur it, and apply a binary mask to starkly contrast the hand shape from the background. This is known as contour detection. And after that, we use a data structure called as DQs in order to store the points of the movement left in our trail by our marker. This is known as frame processing. And finally, to paint on the canvas, we run a loop across the DQ values to trace the stored points. Now, if the starting color of the pencil is blue, and if you want to change it, then we can do so by changing the order of the colors in the color palette list. Here, algorithmic optimization is done. Right side, you can see a person waving his hands in the air is able to write on the screen freely. And this is the demonstration of our project. This is also the exact output of our project, as you can see in the right side. It is a very innovative project. Features of Air Canvas, they include 4 important features. The first one is that it can track any specified color pointer. Second, it is that user can draw in four different colors and even change them without any hassle. Third one would be that it would be able to draw the board with a single location at the top of the screen. Fourth one would be that no need to touch the computer or screen once the program is run, as shown in the demo video. And coming to the conclusion, Air Canvas is an enlightening exploration. Well, Air Canvas is an enlightening exploration into types of interaction afforded by precision-free air interfaces. This touchless technology enables entirely new forms of interaction and makes existing forms cheaper and more effective in various applications where precision sensing of hands and fingers, where a two-dimensional plane is needed. And this is the exact output in the right side, where you can see one of my teammates is actually waving his hands in the air and he's able to write on the screen. This is my teammate Abhinay, and he is executing the whole project. I mean, he's showing the output of the executed project. Future implementations. Well, of course, Air Canvas has many flaws that may be interesting areas of research in the future. The first is the issue of frame rate. Image processing slowed down the camera video feed and produced a cumbersome lag that impedes on the usability of the program. And it would be improved by using multi-core functionality. If the timing problems with queuing data between processes can be managed such that frame information is passed out in order, perhaps Air Canvas can be upgraded to run authentically in real time. Moreover, we relied on the open source OpenCV code for hand recognition, which has its own issues that we worked hard to circumvent. Also, various other advanced sensors can be used for this purpose of multi-touch. Thank you, and this is batch 2.